Remember when Kanye West said out loud, George Bush doesn't care about black people? Well, today, Kanye West has a lot of people wondering if he cares about black people. Rapper Kanye West tweeting today, you don't have to agree with Trump, but the mob can't make me not love him. We are both dragon energy. He is my brother. I love everyone. I don't agree with everything anyone does. That's what makes us individuals, and we have the right to independent thought. Well, the president's response was a simple thank you, Kanye, very cool. So let's discuss now. CNN political commentator Mark Lamont Hill is here. He's the author of Beats, Rhymes, and Classroom Life, Hip Hop, Pedagogy.
That's an old book.
And the politics. I can't see with my new glasses on, politics of identity. And also with me, political commentators Paris Tenard and David Swerdlick. Thank you so much. So I'll give you the first.
Thanks, then.
So he said, he shared about his Twitter love with Ebro on Hot 97. He said that he loves Donald Trump, right?
Yeah.
So, and then he visited him during the 2016 transition.
Yeah.
Why does he love Donald Trump?
And he was at a concert in San Jose on the Pablo tour in 16 and said that if I would have voted, I would have voted for Donald Trump. So he's been shouting out Donald Trump for a long time. I think it's weird. I think it's disappointing to me to see Kanye go from someone who had the courage to stand up and say, George Bush doesn't care about black people, which is a courageous moment of protection and defense of black people and the vulnerable in general, to go to that to defending someone whose campaign was predicated upon white supremacy, white nationalism, erasure of immigrant voices, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It's really disappointing.
This goes beyond, because this is being framed in a frame of this is liberal versus conservative. This is not liberal versus conservative. This is, and that, you know, everyone should have be able to be of whatever.
You can believe what you want. People have a right to believe what they want. And Kanye has a right to believe what he wants. We have a right to hold him accountable for it.
Yeah.
And because he's made so much money off of vulnerable people, in the sense that he makes music for black people, makes music for brown people, makes music that poor people love, to then defend a president and to express love for a president whose policies operate against those interests, to me, is just disappointing. Kanye has a right to do it. I just don't agree with him.
You wrote, David, in the Washington Post, you say that Kanye fell for the worst black Republican sales pitch there is. Explain that.
So I started off talking about what I thought was the best black Republican sales pitch. A couple years ago, Niger Innes, who at the time was a spokesperson for the CORE organization, said to me, the Republican Party is not for people who are rich, it's for people who want to be rich. Now, obviously, leave aside that there are lots of rich black Democrats and there are lots of working class Republicans, it's a good bumper sticker, right? That's a good way to pitch your party. But the pitch that Kanye West fell for, Don, was this idea that he's a free thinker, that black Republicans are free thinkers, and the over 90% of black people who vote for Democrats are not free thinkers. They're either sheep or worse, slaves, which doesn't make sense. The issue, legislative policy priorities of black people, for the most part, line up with the Democratic Party. And so most black people vote for Democrats, which is what all voters do. They look at the two parties, decide which one lines up most with their issue priorities, and they vote for them. It's that simple. And yet somehow we've gotten to this place. This caught on a lot during the Tea Party era. It was starting to be sort of to fizzle out, but a woman named Candace Owens, who's a spokesperson for Turning Point USA, kind of revived this in the last few weeks. This idea that only black people are held to a standard where they can't just vote the issues that they personally prefer.
Okay.
And it's crazy.
So Paris, you know, I mentioned the former president. You previously, had a big moment. You remember this when Kanye had this moment involving the former president, George Bush. Watch this and then we'll discuss.
I hate the way they portray us in the media. If you see a black family, it says they're looting. See a white family, it says they're looking for food. And you know it's been 5 days because most of the people are black.
George Bush doesn't care about black people. Please call.
I still laugh at
Chris Tucker. He's like, oh, Lord. Didn't you work for George Bush, right, Paris?
I proudly worked for President George.
That was a big deal. Do you think Kanye believes that Donald Trump cares about black people?
I think that Kanye West does think that the president cares about black people, but I will go back and say it was not only a big deal to people who knew and know George W. Bush's heart, but President Bush, years later, when asked about one of the things that really upset him or things that he wished he could change, he said that moment really was something that really offended him. Out of all the things, imagine all the things that people said about him, from the wars and the economy and all these things, it was that moment. Because when you utilize these throw these phrases out and call people racist overtly or covertly, it's offensive, especially when you know your heart and know what you've tried to do. Nobody can talk about or question what this president had did for things like PEPFAR and his commitment to reading and literacy and HBCUs and the like. And so it was offensive. But I will tell you this about Kanye West. I haven't liked Kanye West since he said that about President Bush, and I don't like his music now. But I will defend Kanye West's his right to articulate his opinion on politics, especially if it relates to Donald J. Trump or the Make America Great Again agenda. I think it's his right to do it. I'll defend Chance the Rapper's right to do it. I'll defend Shania Twain's right to do it. Because what happens in society these days is if you say anything that's remotely close to conservative, Republican, or supportive of Donald Trump, you're automatically labeled a racist, or you're out of tune with your community, or in this case, Kanye West being called crazy. It's absurd. Well, we should embrace free thinkers.
I think you're, as I said, people are framing this, and that's a small
that's
part.
That's a dishonest
argument. Can we elevate this conversation? Because that's not what it's really about.
Yeah, I heard
that. That's not what it's really about.
Well, I think
that is what it's really
it's
about.
It's not what it's about.
It's about the fact that Kanye West comes out and says something that is in support of this president. Chance the Rapper says something in support of this president. And all of a sudden, Kanye loses millions of Twitter followers. Why?
Well,
it's because
Mark, explain that. Hold on. If you support Republicans
or this president, okay, or you're a conservative, you get
disinvited
from
please.
Campus.
I think, perhaps,
I disagree with your framing of this. And if you look at Twitter and do a search, I mean, this is provable stuff. Most people, you're saying Donald Trump, Kanye West has a right to say what he thinks about Donald Trump. I agree. I don't think there's a large movement of people saying Kanye West doesn't have a right to say this. This is like a right-wing straw argument, this to say that he has free speech. Of course he has free speech.
He shouldn't be demonized for it, is what I should say.
Thank you for correcting yourself. I also don't think that he's being
demonized. I was clarifying.
Same thing, distinction without a difference. I think that he's not being demonized here as much as it is.
He is being demonized.
Well, I'll let you talk.
Did you see his defense? Did you see what his wife has to say? How about this? He is being demonized.
Well, I understand you have a different opinion, but let me say mine and don't cut me off, and I won't cut you off as I didn't. I don't think he's being demonized as much as I think people are challenging him on his perspective, and I think we have a right to do that as well. I think we do have a right to unfollow people in the same way that you said you don't mess with Kanye anymore, you don't buy Kanye stuff anymore after what he said about George Bush. People have a right to not mess with Kanye anymore after what he said about Donald Trump. I think we both have a right to do that. And no, I don't think it's a problem to do so. I think it's actually a part of a robust conversation. I don't think this is a Democrat or Republican thing. And I think the conversation about Kanye West's mental health is a reasonable one. I hope Kanye is great. I don't think that his mental health is in question simply because he supports Donald Trump. If that were the case, there'd be 50 million people whose mental health should be in check. Yeah. I think that little snippet right there is what I'm talking about. I think you missed my point.
Let me finish.
I think you missed my point. What I'm saying is, I don't. I heard you. Okay, I know you heard me. Let America hear me now. I'm saying,
and they did, and they were offended.
Okay, let him finish.
50 million people who you just insulted are offended.
Just let me get five seconds to speak uninterrupted, Paris. You want to see what I'm saying? I'm saying that you're not crazy for voting for Donald Trump, because if that were true, all the 50 million Americans who did would be crazy. I'm saying they are not crazy. I'm saying it's the opposite. I'm saying they are not crazy. See, Paris, if you listen, we reach consensus. My point is that there are other indicators that makes me concerned about Kanye. The blurting out, the hospital, the fact that he was checked into a hospital a few years ago under suspicion of mental health issues. I'm saying I worry about Kanye, not because of who he voted for or would have voted for, but because of other issues.
David, quickly, because I got to get to the break.
Yeah, two things. Look, first of all, Kanye, people are rallying around him, and I think part of what I hear Paris saying is that there's a defense of this idea that black people should be able to be conservative. Yeah. Black people can be conservative. Right. There are plenty of reasons for black people to be conservative and or Republican, but one of them is not that everybody who's a Democrat is just simply, you know, following along like lemmings behind the Democratic Party.
Not the point.
Number two.
I gotta go.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
All right.